So, this is the follow-up video on the Dynasys X1 exoskeleton. Back in April, I was one of the first to try the prototype. And luckily, though I did have some complaints about certain parts, overall, it's a great product that provides a refreshing experience by assisting with walking and running, making an excellent helper for outdoor hikers. The market has proven its value. The crowdfunding campaign was a great success, with over 1,700 bikers raising almost $1.4 million. Wow, congrats to them. Exoskeleton products like this are really gaining popularity. Recently, I noted that Arc'teryx released a knee joint exoskeleton that has also garnered a lot of attention. In fact, Dynasys showed me their own knee joint exoskeleton, which they actually developed last year and plan to release in the first half of next year, much earlier than Arc'teryx project timeline. Due to confidentiality, I can't say much more, but it's definitely something to look forward to. Anyway, more about the X1. Now, after 5 months, they are ready to ship. In this video, I'm going to focus on what's been updated and my overall experience using it. First impressions, the weight, right out of the box. By the way, this should be the final packaging, and they'll include a high quality portable case like this, with all the parts securely locked in place. For the X1, it feels a little bit lighter than the one I tried in April. Great, the lighter, the better. Next, the design. The first thing I noticed was they adopted a softer and a wider belt, especially around the waist, which definitely provides better support. As for the front belly part, they've used a double-layered Velcro design that's more comfortable and, most importantly, more secure. Even when you're running fast, it won't fall off and it stays firmly in place. In my last video, based on my personal experience, I suggested 2 areas for improvement: the battery design and the mode selection for assistance. Let's talk about the battery. Last time, I complained that putting the battery in the pocket wasn't a good design, and they promised to create a clip so the battery could be attached directly to the belt. No, they've done it, and I really like it. No matter how I move, the cable won't interfere with its use. Additionally, by replacing the base with one that has a Type-C port, you can even charge your phone. As for the mode adjustment, previously it was just a beep sound, which wasn't very user-friendly for someone like me who isn't musically inclined. No, they made it so that the left mode button decreases assistance and the right one increases it, letting you choose between more assistance or resistance mode. Awesome! And it's even accompanied by different lights, adding a high-tech feel. And those two changes were ones I personally mentioned, and I'm really happy to see them implemented. In fact, as I browsed through some tech reviews and user feedback on the X1, I noticed they made other improvements based on those suggestions too. They even adjusted parts I didn't think needed improvement, like increasing the distance between the motor and the belt because some users found the previous design too tight and uncomfortable. They also made enhancements in areas I thought were perfectly fine, such as reducing the motor noise during operation. Oh, speaking of giving feedback, one way you can do it is by submitting directly through the app, which is managed by someone from the official Dynasys team. The app has also seen significant improvements compared to the version I had in April. The best thing I noticed is that they've added a detailed, step-by-step, foolproof tutorial. You know, since this kind of product is relatively new, unlike our phones, a tutorial is a must-have. Just follow it and you'll get the hang of it in no time. I discovered some new modes, Aqua Mode and Aqua Plus Mode, which are essentially resistance modes that help protect your knees or burn your calories more efficiently. And they even charge the battery while you're using them. I also came across another new mode, Boost Mode, which offers the most powerful assistance, helping you run even faster. It's hard to visually convey the experience, so I'll describe it. The assistance feels noticeably stronger and smoother compared to the previous model, almost like an invisible force gently propelling your legs forward, making running and climbing much less strenuous. Alright, that covers all the improvements of the X1, and just 3 of the Dynasys has finally made it. They listened to user feedback and made the necessary upgrades. And now, all the bikers are finally going to get their hands on it. It's hard to truly grasp how this thing works until you try it yourself. With all these improvements, I like it even more. and I've personally bought one with my own money. I'll be updating you with an official unboxing and long-term review later, so make sure to subscribe. If you have any other questions, feel free to leave them below. And yes, stay tuned for the knee joint exoskeleton experiment next year. Thanks for watching, I'm Samuel, see you in the next one. Bye-bye.